the second scariest one is the guy was shooting this way, and I saw his gun, it was a revolver, so I knew it only had 6 bullets. So he goes, bang, 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 and then about the 4th shot in, I start to run at him, he goes, 5, and I'm where you're standing. He goes, 6 shots, and I'm thinking, oh, perfect, right? All of a sudden he goes, 7 shots, and I'm like, oh no, what the hell? And he goes, 8 shots, I'm like, oh shit. Now I'm point blank with him, and he goes,
and
had 8 shots, because it was a revolver with 8 in the cylinder, and I'd never seen one of those before, and I was just, it was freaking just a huge miscalculation on my part. But
so Lady Luck smiles on you in that case.
Yeah, dude, I've had a lot of Lady Luck smiling on me, actually. I feel like if you do good work, you know, good stuff happens to you. You know, so these are the bad streets. You can see the people on the corners here.
Yeah.
Tourist area. So tourists walk around and get kind of jacked on these sides. When we get to closer to the bar close, when all the drunks and violent people come out, that's one area to be in. And it's real dumb. And it's less gritty because you can just stand there and wait. It's guaranteed there's going to be a fight.
There's always a fight.
Yeah, it doesn't matter how many police are there at that moment. Sometimes there's so much police in that neighborhood because they know how bad it is that there's no point in us standing there. Other nights we walk in, there's no police, and we have to basically stand out in front of a bar all night and wait for the fight, you know?
But I mean, the police are obviously aware of the danger areas too.
Yeah, they are. They actually upped their patrols and money recently, but they ran out of money and funding for it. So I'm not sure how many cops will be out there. It's sort of hit and miss. They don't tell you, you know, they told you they ran out of money, but they won't tell you when they're going to take it off.
No.
That way the criminals don't. Everyone has their positions that they're good at. Okay? The problem here is we have a lot of guys good at the same thing. These two guys don't know what the fuck they're doing. So their position is don't do anything. You get what I'm saying?
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
You're
either.
Not to involve yourself at all. You're just to watch and simply be support and backup. This is the camera guy. You make sure he does not get punched.
You're support
and
shot.
Him, okay? And if a crime comes, I'd like you to record it. That would help me.
Yeah,
that's
for
the best
sure.
thing that could happen. You, instinctively, will make sure nothing happens to them. And you already are a good floater. So I'm not going to give you a position on the squad because you're going to be torn between making sure nothing happens to them and doing your job. Jack, you should be my number one guy. You should know where to be, what to do, when to be on point, how to be a perfect. So I'm not going to give you a position because you should already know that.
Gotcha.
Cabby can't stick to a position because he sees shit that we just don't see and goes places we don't understand. So I'm not going to give Cabby a position because he won't stick to it. So the only thing we know for sure is I'm going to go in on point. And all you guys make sure that you do what you feel is appropriate.
So
you
you're going to run off.
And you make sure I'm cool and they're cool. That's really all I can,
So essentially, you're going to run off. I'm going to chase you and everybody else is doing it.
Well, Cabby
is almost flawed in my opinion. It seems to take away from just us being regular people who want to conceal our identities for our own safety and protect the people around. I don't really consider myself super. I can't fly. I can't shoot lightning out of my hands or anything.
But like, wouldn't you say that, I mean, the word super actually comes from the deeds you do and then the kind of mentality you have towards what you're doing?
That's a valid argument. It's just the archetype, I guess, is the right word. It makes a statement, and our statement is people have the right to say, to dictate what they're willing to tolerate in their own like area of living. If you don't want people to get assaulted in your area, do something about it. Be a good witness. Call the police. Don't sit idly by while people take advantage of you, of people around you. And if calling myself a superhero will do that, okay, I guess I'm a superhero.
I heard about a couple of my friends, they've got mugged down here. So, I came up here and I set up shop right up here. Right there.
Yeah?
Dressed in my suit and I waited for the gang.
Just you?
Yeah, just me by myself. It was back in the old days. And I waited for the guys to come.
When you say the old days, like how long ago?
Probably like 2 years. Two and a half years. So I waited for the guys to come down, right? I saw the biker come. And the biker came down this trail right here. And right when he got to right about there, boom, you know, he gets, the string hits him, dehorses him, you know, he's on his back, and right behind all this part right here, and under there, these gang guys start coming out,
right?
Yeah? Like how many?
Maybe like 6 or 7.
Fuck. And I mean, there's a lot of places in this world, like Joburg, that need fucking superheroes, right?
Yeah.
So why is it mostly happening in North America? Why do you reckon? Any thoughts on that subject?
North America has a very liberal, open-minded group of people. Hollywood is very superhero friendly.
Yeah, and there's the comic book culture.
There's a culture here already. So, whereas...
Let's just see if they see him run by, shirtless down the middle of the fucking road, high as a motherfucker. Let's see if that works.
At least flash the cops and have them look over
here? Don't flash the cops. They don't want to see that, man.
I don't even like a light flash. They don't want that.
A light flash to see if you think you should have.
He's running out of steam.
When you're in drugs, you can do that.
I know, I remember.
Are you kidding me?
Did you get the code?
What's the code?
Code 2.
Means that they're gonna investigate. We should keep eye line of sight. So if something happens, we can jump in real quick without having to radio with them.
Alright.
Far beyond the fact of just wanting to be a crime fighter, you have to want to change your entire way you look at the world. I would say that Phoenix is definitely the mask, but I enjoy being Phoenix much more than I enjoy being Bane. When I put the mask on, none of that shit really matters anymore. You just gotta make sure you don't die. And working on one thing, just being totally single-minded in one aspect is a lot easier than having to be multidimensional, you know?
You say that maybe the fact that you actually conceal your identity makes you not so much a person, but a symbol, you know?
I'm a symbol of every
symbol of what you just explained.
A symbol of every man. Anyone could be under here. Anyone could be under there. Could be your neighbor, could be your friend, could be anyone.
Okay.
I like how I'm living right now.
This is how it's going to happen.
I like this.
I'm going to go through all of my gear sites.
Thank you.
I'm going to send you one. Pictures of masks. Once we come to an agreement on the mask Ghost should wear, not because it makes him look stupid, because if we want him to look stupid, we leave him in that.
That, yeah. We leave him with whatever mask he brings up.
Exactly. So, that's how it is. I'll find it. You ratify it. That's kind of... The motion is seconded, we make Ghost find that man. Because this is a hell no
this
moment.
This is working for me.
Aerobics with El Caballero.
Caballero. Oh, my name's cool.
My name's
Eat your veggies.
But I mean, like, we have to be witnesses for them.
Come, give us a bit of... Oh, that's cool.
It's important to get them on the street because one of the positive things about SPD, they do offer programs for getting people clean. So it's actually good that he's getting looked at.
That is cool. Does it usually take 3 cop cars to apprehend a crazy bum?
They're a bit excessive.
I like that style.
Yeah, me too. That was awesome.
In a country where there are corrupt people, I'm not saying that there are of them, but they are. You go to a comic book, you go to a fantasy world.
Yeah.
Superman has not. I mean, he has been corrupted in some sense. He has become a bad guy. But all in all, that's because of brainwashing. That's because of kryptonite. That's because of something, you know?
Okay.
But Superman stands up for what he believes in. And he's always stand up for what he believes in. And that's why people go to comic books, people go to fantasy, people go to video games and all that stuff. Because they have heroes there that won't be corrupt.
That are iconic, you
know, that
stand
iconic.
For very simple truths and justices.
Yeah.
Even though the world isn't that simple.
Yeah,
but now...
You don't wake up one day and think it's a logical answer to put on a costume and fight crime. Like, there has to be something that, you know...
A catalyst, either a direct response. Point.
Yeah. Like, it's not a logical thing to wake up one day and just say, hey, I'm going to go fight criminals.
Well, even, I mean, like, you look at the superheroes in the comics, man, back to that fantasy world, and there is always, usually, some sort of tragedy that is the catalyst. I mean, Superman's planet's destroyed, Batman's parents are murdered, Spider-Man loses Uncle Ben. There's something really, really horrible that happens.
And honestly, I think that's something that parallels reality. Because I'm not going to tell everyone's story, but I've had personal tragedies. Yes, yeah. We all have. And I think that is a parallel.
We all have a sense of humor because, one, we're in superhero suits in the real world. Now, one, you can't take
that is comical.
Seriously.
I think he's beyond hearing. He's hearing, but he's not comprehending.
Yeah, he is. He's right on the sidewalk.
And he's back in the road again.
Dude!
He's not comprehending.
This is back in my vigilante-ish days. I'm not like this anymore.
Uh-huh. You think things through now.
Yeah. I had marbles loaded up inside a paintball gun. And I came around and I was like, blast marbles. I was like, oh! Right? So I dropped that and I immediately threw a smoke bomb. That's right? I kept running in. Bang! Dude falls off into the grass, right? Another dude comes, hits me, I come this way, I'm kind of confused, I hit another dude, and that's when I realized the paintball guys got up off the ground, a couple of them got knives.
Yeah.
So at this time the biker gets up and he's got his bike and just takes off, right?
Yeah.
So I grab his bag, throw it over my pack, and I run this way. So I got this bag and these like six guys chasing me because one guy's still out. So I'm running this way.
Even the time in which we busted a guy who had stabbed another guy, the guy who he stabbed had a warrant for his arrest, too.
Fuck. Two birds with one stone, so to speak. Well, at least he's not running around anymore.
Yeah. I was just worried, even beyond him acting stupid, is someone going to work, you know.
Yeah.
Just barely drinking their coffee and getting hit running right into him.
The police deemed that he was high on drugs, took him into the station to get him tested. Okay?
Yeah.
So, people like, you run into crime all the time, but not really. We sort of made, we watched our case. We did it from the beginning. We saw a guy strange. We watched him pick up his clothes. We watched him run around. We reported to the authorities. We stayed to witness the crime. It's it's not like people like, oh, you just walk into crime. Like, no, I don't. I walked into a hella weird guy rubbing his belly.
Who could have posed a danger to himself and others.
Right. Then he took off his clothes. Then he started getting aggressive. Then he started running in the street. But I mean, at first glance, most people see the guy with his shrubbing his belly and like, oh, gosh, here's just walking the other way. That's why they don't find crime. It's not like you just happen to have this, like, crime magnet.
Cops like to use the word, he injects himself in the situations where clearly you see we didn't do that.
Yeah, you make him sound like a drug, man.
The crazy, just multiply.
You know what I'm saying? But it just, I think it's funny when people are like, well, it's just because I live, there's no crime. No, you don't know how to look for crime because you're an idiot.
It's almost, I mean, you're not injecting yourself in the crime, and you're certainly not making it happen. You're kind of preceding it before it happens.
Yeah.
You're getting
we've seen this movie before, so I just cut to this end scene.
Yeah.
I guess part of me does enjoy being called a superhero because it makes people think. I don't care if they consider me a real superhero or not. I don't consider myself a real superhero. But it makes people think. Like, if you hear someone say, there's a neighborhood watch group in Seattle, no one will pay attention.
Yeah.
But if you say there's a superhero group in Seattle, people will start looking that up on Google.
Yeah, yeah.
And maybe they'll be like, hey, all this really is people looking out for one another and trying to help one another. And then maybe they'll be like, well, that's not that hard. Maybe I can do something with this. Our existence should be unnecessary in a civilized society.
you guys see yourself doing this indefinitely?
Well, I don't see crime ceasing anytime soon.
There's only one goal, stop violence.
Yeah.
And no matter what happens in between, there's right and there's wrong, but it's easy to be in the right when you just look for someone socking another dude in the face, you know?
I'm a guy who loves comics, who saw a problem and found a unique way to fix it. I'm gonna do this until I get killed or they find someone better.